Welcome to the edition of Let's Play Farming Simulator 2013 on The American Farm. Alright, so, back again with a continuation of our previous harvest. Well, not our previous harvest. Well, doing the circuit, I should say. So we currently got our John Deere 9630. He is currently planting this field with soybeans. Funny enough, I tried out... What happened was the sprayer, the fertilizer, actually ran out before the seed did in that with this particular setup, which is kind of funny. So you have to kind of be a little careful with course play when it goes back to get more seed and fertilizer. So you have to place it at the appropriate place before setting them up again, or else you'll have like a chunk of your field not planted with anything. So it's a bit odd, but it makes sense, I guess. I thought I was going to be really close, so they'd both run out at the same time, but it doesn't work that way. Just the way it goes sometimes. All right, so we have our John Deere currently harvesting our corn over here. Just a quick little jaunt over here. So he's harvesting our corn. He's using a hard worker this time, not course play, due to the fact that that corn header does not play well with course play. For whatever reason, it wants to unfold it every single time. I think what happens is when it wants to unfold, it really means lift up. But that's the way it lifts up, I guess. It triggers the unfold feature, I guess. So as you can see, we got them. Those two guys, they're rolling there. I don't know how far down the field. I don't know, about maybe 10%, maybe. Hard to say. Anyway, so let's head over here. Our cows are running out of total mixed rations, so we need to get on that. Now, what that means is we have to fiddle with... our mixing wagon. There's nothing in it. Let's just double check. No, good. So we're gonna try and get the appropriate mix for this. Let's just ensure that it does have the appropriate mix. Release that handbrake as always. All right. So do we have the same size bales? Whoops. Meant to go backwards, not forwards. Do we have the same size bales over here? Looks like we have... Okay. So what we're going to try and do is we are going to put one of these round hay bales first. And then go from there. Now, what actually might work a bit better... with this, the way I have the current setup is if I use the self-propelled mixing wagon. And the only reason because of that is because it'd be a bit easier to adjust how much silage we're getting. Now, I could either do that, which is kind of on the expensive side, I suppose, because they are 130,000, something like that. So. The other option, of course, would be to just get a bucket, I suppose. Which is a lot cheaper, but not nearly as much fun. There we go, good. That was weird. I wonder why I got so loud there for a second. Huh. So that's the other option, is getting a bucket and just doing it that way. And I don't like doing it that way, but it's a bit more controlled than using the conveyor belt that I normally use. So that is what I'm kind of thinking about at the moment in terms of dealing with those with the mixed rations, at least. So like I mentioned last episode, I think it was, about using the remote control on my phone to record videos. So far it's worked all right. I like the feature that shows you how long you've been recording for, and it makes it a lot easier to pause, because I don't normally pause videos, but it does have that capability. I tend to hit other keys when I pause for whatever reason. I don't know why, but just the way it is. All right, now how much do we have in here? 50%, 50%. 6,400 liters. Now, if I fill the rest up with silage, I wonder how much. I'm gonna put one more hay bale in there, I think. Now the funny thing is, now that I've been using these round bales, starting to figure it out. The problem I'm going to have now is the rest of my hay is actually not in round bales. It looks like, yeah. Now, we do have one of these, so let's try and get one of these wrapped bales over here that we haven't used yet. I believe this is considered. Did I get it? No, not even close. When these bales are actually the full size, it's a lot easier to tell when you're close to them. But when you're dealing with these small bales like this, it's not so much fun. There we go, got it. Just because these actually are realistically sized, based on how much, like those are the, that's what actual size it is right there. But for whatever reason, the wrapper we have breaks them down to smaller, well, resizes it basically. Whoops. Whoa. It resizes it. Alright, so that might have been just a wee bit too much. Maybe not. The problem is still going to be the fact that, I don't know, we'll see. They weren't all the same size bales. And as you can see, after putting that bale in there, it considers it as hay, not as silage, which is a bit unfortunate. It would make more sense if it was considered silage, but... Alright, now let's top the rest of this off with... Oh, that is topped off. Shoot. So, what we're gonna have to try and do is... give some more of this to the pigs and then see if we can add some more silage, thereby getting a good mix. And this is always a problem. Like, if you, and by problem I mean this is what happens when, oh well, this is always the situation when you use the hay bales and whatnot to make a mixed ration. You always have to get the right mix. Now, in my case, I made it harder for myself because I use the conveyor belt. Just now that I think about it, was not the best thing to do. Really? Come on now. Urgh. And also the fact that my hay bales aren't the same size as my straw bales kind of adds to that a little bit. So that is the other problem I've encountered, basically. Alright, so we might as well fuel up this tractor while we're over here on the side of our farm, or on this side, I should say, because we only have 10 liters left, and we need to make sure we don't get stuck anywhere. Looks like we're good after this. Well, once it's fueling, what we'll do is we'll just keep an eye, go check on the New Holland to see how he's doing with the John Deere there. Refuel. Let's take a quick little peek. He's doing well. Excellent. So yeah, I guess the hired worker is the way to go with that particular setup. I don't have my farm all on here. Let's put it with group 3. Some people ask me why I have the group situation set up. Just makes it easier, so I don't have to tab through every single vehicle I have. Now, right now, it's not so bad because I only have like a few vehicles, but if I were to have, you know, like 20 or so vehicles, it would make it a pain. Now, what's that giving them? Silage and grass. Okay, so let's go fill this up with... let's go fill the rest up with silage to see if it makes it as a perfect mix. That thing makes so much noise, I can't believe it. I don't know why, it's the mixing wagon, all I can hear in my earphones is just that, the loud sound of that, it's crazy. Oh, goodness. So I was talking to the missus the other day about the farm, and she was thinking about that high yield we got a while back and what's happened with that. And so far, she seems okay with it. She didn't think it was anything to do with chemicals, luckily, or any kind of thing like that. So seems like we'll be here until we finish up on this farm, which in reality means completing our goals, which is pretty darn close now, I suppose. Alright, let's top this off. So she's okay with it so far, so we'll see what happens. Yes, perfect. That's what we're looking for. So we'll see what happens with that. The neighbors have become a little bit more nicer to me since we've been here for a while. They like the farm for the most part, they just don't like the smell from the pigs. Other than that, they're pretty chill with me, which is nice, so. It's always good to have good neighbors, in real life and in video games. Especially if you play on a multiplayer server of some sort. Alright, let's give them some mixed rations. Excellent. This is perfect. It's funny, when we first started out the season about not using the mixing wagon, or not using the mixing station, I was afraid I was going to have to do a lot of front loader stuff. And it's true, I did have to. But I don't mind it, actually. It's not so bad. If I had to do it for like a half an hour or an hour, then yeah, I probably would not enjoy it quite as much. But for the small amount I actually do use it, would have to fill this thing up, it's not nearly as bad as I thought it was going to be, so that is really nice. So yeah, the farm's come along quite a long way, actually. Since we only started with that one field and a small combine, now we have some big equipment. We got the precision air seeder, we got the John Deere 690i or S690i, so progressed quite a bit, actually, considering from our beginning, I guess, is what it boils down to. So it's been pretty good. Luckily, the misses, if you recall, one of the reasons why we moved here initially was to be closer to family. Now move to our map here in America was to be close to family, and she's appreciated the time being with them, but she would like to be maybe a bit closer. She hasn't decided yet. We'll have to see what she has to say about our next farm, because we're what you might call serial farmers, in the sense that you start a farm, leave, and start a farm. That's weird. Don't like settling down too much, I guess. There we go. Our cows are taken care of for now. I'm not going to give our pigs mixed rations, because that would just be too much of a pain. Undoubtedly. Excellent. Alright. So, let's take a quick peek at our inventory to see what we have. Inventory. See what we got in the silos. We got barley in the silos, we got canola in the silos, corn in the silos, and soybeans. Now, let's just check. I don't know why I went out of that. There. Stop there. we have manure, soybeans, and barley coming up. So we're going to hold on the barley, and we're going to hold on the soybeans. But we have... barley's coming up too, eh? Should plant some barley, apparently, then. But we have some corn, so let's go ahead and sell some corn, because we want to get... we want to revitalize our bank account a little bit here. What's the best place to sell corn at? The freight yard. Yeah, it looks like the freight yard. 271 at the freight yard. Alright, so let's hop in our Peterbilt here, and go for a drive. It's cool. I was watching, I found a person on YouTube, and he does this, I don't know what you call it. It's a Sunday drive, I think is what he does, type deal. And basically that's his way of exploring the map, a new map in Farming Simulator. His YouTube channel is Dr. Vesuvius. He does like a little Sunday drive type thing with this car, or this Jeep. It's pretty cool. Reminds me a bit of the Gray Gamer and how he has his truck branded, I suppose. I don't have any of that. I just stick to what we got. All right, corn. Here we are. Perfect. What? So some people have been weighing in on the fact that I've considered doing a dual season almost sort of thing. So do like a one small map and one big map sort of idea. Some people have weighed in on that, and they said, some people are like, yeah, it's a good idea. And other people in the comments have suggested one season's fine. For the most part, people seem okay with it. And now it's the John Deere. Let's just keep an eye on him, because he is most undoubtedly going to have problems. So I'm just going to take control over here. Yeah, so some people have said, yeah, that's cool. Other people haven't said much about it. So I'm considering doing it, but if I do make one, like, or if I do make some sort of dual season, it'll be one shorter episode and one longer episode. But they'll be on different maps, basically. So as you can see, he actually seeded, or he actually fertilized further than he seeded. As you can see. So there's a bit of waste when you use this, if you're not paying attention, like I don't, apparently. But where are you going? Didn't want to start right there. He wants to start at his other point. I don't want him to start there because he needs to seed the rest of this. Alright, let's unfold the seeder here. Maybe if I start doing it, he will continue. It's hard to say. Course plays a funny thing. So this is what I'll do. I'll just reset the course and start it, because that usually works. Did I not save that course? Oh goodness, I'm sure I did. Apparently I didn't. I get the feeling that I did, but I just, oh no, there it is, it's right at the bottom. Alright, there we go. Yeah, so as you can see, on this case, he actually fertilizes further than he... there's more in the tank for fertilizer than there is for seed, so... Looks like he only got a little bit of a row done, so it's not too much waste, but it is still wasteful, so... Let's put our tarp on our Cornhusker trailer here. Good. Excellent. Freight yard. Now, I need to check my notes to see which one's the freight yard. It's funny when that happens, because if people don't label them the same way they are, like if they don't have put signs down, that's what I'm getting at. If they put signs down, it's easy to figure it out, but if they don't put signs down, it makes it a lot more difficult. That's one thing I've actually kind of noticed about a lot of maps I play that are German maps or looked at. They tend to have really good signage. I don't know why, but they have really good signage, so it's easy to find out... figure out where you're going. Like, even though sometimes it's in German, like, you can kind of figure out certain places, like, if you see Schweinemast, for example, that's, like, where the pigs usually are, because, of course, in English, swine is another name for pigs, I suppose. I don't know if you guys remember the old... It wasn't old, but I guess it was a while ago. There was a problem called... And they house... Originally, it was called the H1... the swine flu, sorry. It was called the swine flu. And what actually happened is, because it was labeled the swine flu, because apparently... I'm not sure how it originated, but... They rebranded it, or renamed it the H1N1 virus. And interestingly enough, it actually affected farmers, pig farmers quite a bit, because there was the name swine, which people recognize as a pig. So because it was called the swine flu, a lot of people didn't want to buy a pig because they thought they were going to get sick from it. Now, that's really silly, and people should be a little bit more of a critical thinker, I guess is what I'm going for. But you know, sometimes, you know, the media plays these things up and can kind of play tricks on you to a certain extent. I'm just going to drive through the yard here. So, what actually happened was the price of pork went down considerably, and a lot of some pig farmers went out of business because of that. So, just to give you a little bit of an idea of how something as simple as something like the name of something can really affect farmers. It's all integrated somehow. So, like these days right now, one of the big trends is all about organic and whatnot. So if you have organic, that looks so cool. Sorry. Let's take this way around. With the organic stuff and whatnot. So a lot of times people are saying, oh yeah, we're organic and whatnot. I don't know if this goes all the way around the way I want it to. Does it? No. So I guess we can't go that way. Never mind. So a lot of people want organic stuff. But the funny thing is, unless it is certified, like, let me put it this way. In a farmer's market, you may see a sign that says organic. Now, because they say organic doesn't necessarily mean they're certified organic. It's actually really, really difficult to get a certified organic farm. It is, you have to be really picky about what comes on your farm and who comes on your farm, because if they bring something in that taints your certification in terms of organic, it can really wreak havoc on certain things. So what some farmers have done is they've said what they'll do is they'll say it's pesticide free or herbicide free or something like that, basically as an indication to say we don't use chemicals on our plant, sort of idea. Now, not everyone does this, obviously, and it's not feasible for everybody, but it is one of the ways people are trying to say, well, we understand you want more organic food, here's our response, sort of thing. So it's interesting to see the way certain farmers will react to, trends, I guess is what I'll say. Because they are trends in the end, right? So. But it is pretty interesting. Like I know people who would prefer to have like a hole in a potato, for example, where a bug might be, because they know they didn't use pesticides on their potatoes. Like things like that. It's kind of interesting to see where some people have gone, to the extent of what some people have gone for things like that, because it's becoming a serious issue these days in terms of what's safe to eat, almost, which is kind of interesting, because some people will, like, for example, you have whole trends in regards to vegetarianism, so you only eat organic food and all that jazz. So it's kind of in almost some regards it's gone kind of crazy, but it's you'd be surprised how much some stuff like that can make a difference. Like, I'm not an advocate for 100% organic and all that jazz. One, because it's just expensive, and two, because it's not always beneficial to buy something that's organic. Like, even if you look in the stores, like, here's another one of my pet peeves, is if you go to a grocery store and you buy a bag of apples, let's say, because I eat a lot of apples, and on the bag it may say product of Canada, but the silly thing is, it may not have been grown in Canada, but just packaged in Canada. So things like that, you really got to pay attention to, especially in this day and age, because marketers are really sneaky when it comes to that type of stuff, because they'll know that people are looking for, oh, I need organic stuff, or I need this, or I need that. So because of that, they're really trying to take advantage of people not knowing certain things. So I encourage you as consumers to be aware of those types of things, because for your own sound of mind sort of idea. So what I'm trying to say is be educated a bit, I guess. Oh my goodness, that was quite a rant. I'm sorry. Did not expect that one to come out. Oh man, must have been the soup I just had. I have no idea. But yeah, I don't know. I buy a lot of carrots and apples, so I tend to look at the packaging quite a bit to see where it was grown and where it was packaged and stuff like that. I don't know. If it's possible, I try to buy not necessarily organic, but grown in Ontario, because that's where I'm from in Canada. So I try and buy grown in Ontario, basically, stuff, if I can. It's not always possible. Like, I really like Gala apples, they're called, and they can't always be... They are grown in Canada, but they're only available after the harvest, so basically that's around October area, I believe. So they're only available around that time, and you can get them a bit further after that. Like, I think right now we're still getting Ontario apples, but it won't last throughout the whole winter, because if you store an apple for that long, it's just not going to be a good apple, basically. So, I tend to keep an eye on that type of stuff. And when Ontario's not available, then... if it's not available in Ontario, it's usually not available in Canada, because we have a... While the weather itself may change, it's not crazy different, like, in the sense that... it's not that different in the sense that there's no winter. I think the only place in Canada where we don't have where there isn't a winter kind of is, I guess, Victoria, BC on the island there. I think that's the only place that I know of offhand that kind of has a mild winter. I think I've never been there, so if you're from Victoria, BC or out west, let me know. I know in BC, the province itself, it gets really crazy there in terms of weather, but well. Alright, so we have $123,000. This is good. This is good. So this is going to give us... how much corn do we have left? Do we have enough for another load? Yes, we do. Let's do one more load of corn and see where we end up at. Because we want to keep the canola and we want to keep the soybeans for the great demand and then go from there. Yeah, because we're not going to get a crazy amount from corn. Not as much as the soybeans or oats, for that matter. It'll give us a little bit. I just remembered something. One of the things I was going to mention to you guys last episode was about the mod I downloaded and tested out. Or hadn't tested out yet. So I've tested out the mod now, and it does function. It works. It's a nice mod. Basically what it is here, let me just show you what it is. It's the Case IH Axial Flow 9230. Now this is a mod and it's not the titanium pack, which is interesting. Why is Case is upside down apparently? That's kind of strange on both of them. Weird. So this is actually a mod and not from the titanium pack, but it's pretty much identical to the titanium pack. This actually is not the right size. The titanium pack one, I believe, is 12 meters, not 10.5, but little quibbles. I did test it out on another map, and it works, so that's good. So we could aim towards that, but in all honesty, it's not really worth it because our current combine's the same size, which is kind of funny. If we'd want to upgrade or get another combine, yeah, maybe we'll do that for another combine, but in terms of an upgrade, it wouldn't really be an upgrade because it's the same size. The only upgrade aspect would be the increased size in the tank, basically. That's it, believe it or not. So, alright, we got one more load of corn to go, and then we'll see where we're at in terms of cash. We may have enough for another field, depending on which field we decide to get. Actually, you know what we'll do is we'll wait on buying a field, because after the great demand, We will most definitely have enough money for one of the fields. Let's check on this John Deere. What's he up to? Is he just returning to the first point? Looks like he is, yes. So he is done, it looks like. Excellent. So he only needs to refill once, which is nice. I think the other seeder needed to refill a couple times before. So this is good. Finished work. Excellent. So I do like this seeder now that I've used it a bit more. I hadn't used it much off camera, to be honest with you. And when I had the more realistic mod installed, this seeder and this fertilizer was just ridiculous to fill up. Because the more realistic mod adjusted the price of the fertilizer and seed, so it made it extremely expensive to fill this up. So now that I don't have it installed, it's actually not. I think it's more realistic now. Not sure, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't cost like $1 million to fill this thing up. But when I was using it before, it did, so we'll figure. I'm just gonna stick it over here for the time being. This should be out of the way. I don't want to take it. I don't want to detach it because that would just be painful to attach it together. Oh well. All right, we got one more load of corn, and then we'll see where we are at. Let's head out. Put the tarp on there. There we go. Excellent. So our cows are happy. Our chickens are always happy. You don't have to give the chickens anything and they're happy. So, alright, so let me know what you guys think about that double map thing. This is what I'm thinking in terms of length. I would have like a normal 30 to 40 minute episode on a larger map, and then like a short episode on a small map that I would probably do more manual stuff. John, I believe, suggested that I do a more realistic small map, which actually would require me to do more stuff manually, which is fine because it'd be a smaller map. So that is a possibility for sure. I actually have a couple maps in mind for something like that already. Maps I was thinking about doing using before, so it's definitely possible. So, and that would, the funny thing about that is that would mean I probably wouldn't use course play nearly as much, because more realistic and course play mod do not play well together. The new course play is supposed to, at least, but I don't have that. It's in developer mode still. Alright, so let's see where we're at in terms of corn. Not in terms of corn, in terms of how much money we have, because after it hits 11 o'clock, it is going to tank. Surely. Alright. No cars, good. I do like how open this map is. Sometimes I want to use bigger equipment and I can't, just because of the size of the map. What are we at? 135, 140, almost 142. It's not too bad at all. All right, let's just leave this here for the time being for a quick sec. And let's go check on our combine. How's he doing? Where is he at? Oh, he's about halfway done now. It's not too bad. Too bad. I think what we'll do next episode is, what I'll do is I'll clean the equipment, because I haven't cleaned any of my equipment yet, and it looks kind of dirty, so, especially this one. I don't know why, the texture on the dirt mod in this looks not very good, I guess is what it boils down to. It's funny, this combine, after using it a little bit, there's some things I really like about it. Like, I like the fact that the head rotates, so it can adjust for hills, base is what it boils down to. I really like that fact. I don't like the way it looks very much. It's a little, it needs a bit more, I don't know what the word I look for. It needs a bit more texture, I guess. It's kind of just green and that's it. So it looks like a little bit of an unfinished texture for the actual combine itself. If it was a bit more high res, maybe I think I would like it a bit more. And it doesn't seem to act like a combine. It's a bit peppy, but I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just picky. But I did check out, like I said, I checked out these combines here, and they actually look pretty good. Nothing fancy. It's just a standard combine, and that's it. But I'm happy I have. This is one of the nicer case combines that I've actually seen, so I'm really pleased about that. Although it would be funny now if Giant said, hey, guess what? The new version of Farming Simulator is coming out this day. And they'd be like, well, I guess I'll just wait for that then. Anyways, all right, so I'll stop it there for the time being, ladies and gentlemen, and we shall return. And what we'll do is, the starting of the next episode, we'll start seeding this field. And we'll do a couple other things next episode. I think what we'll do is we'll wash the equipment as well, because we have a couple things that need to be washed. And what I'll do is I'll... how many days are we... Oops. We need 2 days for soybeans. 2 days. What I'll do, I think, is I'll do a harvest off camera. And then I'll come back when it's a soybean great demand, I think. And then during that time, we shall wash the equipment, I guess. We might have a harvest going on at the same time. We'll see. Not sure. So what I'll do for sure is we'll return when we have the soybean great demand. I was going to say soybean harvest. So anyways, we'll see from there. All right, so my name is Ian Robson. This has been Farming Simulator 2013, and we're playing on the American Farm. Catch you guys later.